Hi, welcome to this question right here. So here we are trying to do some factoring, but this time we get a number in the front of x squared. So it's a little bit harder, but this is a trick, okay? Before you even start with the bracket, okay? We're gonna do a little bit something that's called a little bit of guessing, all right? First thing you do is you have to think of the factor that gives you 9, the factors of 9, basically. We've got a 1 and 9 and 3 and 3. Now, personally, I don't like the 1 and 9. I like to go with the 3 and 3, okay? So let's just go ahead and do that. Let's put a 3 and 3 just below the 9, okay? Now, on the other side over here, we'll have a look at the 2 over here. Now, the factors of 2 is just 1 and 2, okay? So let's say we're just going to do randomly. Let's put 1 and 2 down, okay? So let's put a 1 right here and put a 2 right here. Now, the trick is you have to do something that's called cross multiplying, all right? Now, why are we doing this? You will see. 3 times 1, we're cross multiplying here. 3 times 1 is a 3, and 3 times 2 is a 6, okay? These two numbers here, you have to add them up to get you a positive 3. So what that means is, this must be a 6 positive, and this one here must be a negative 3, okay? So where does negative come from? It has to come from the negative 1 at the front. Now, how does it make sense? Well, let's all go back to the very beginning. These two numbers here are the factors of 9. So what that means is 3 times 3 gives you the 9, which is true. These two numbers here are the factors of the 2. But remember this one? It was a negative, right? So one of them has to be a negative, but we weren't sure yet. So that's why I just do the math, and I look at the answer over here. I know by adding and subtracting, I need to get the 3, okay? So that means a negative 3 is here, and that means this must be a negative 1, okay? So here, let's just double check. 2 times negative 1 does give me negative 2. Cross multiplying, like 3 times negative 1 is negative 3. 3 times 2 is 6. By adding them, I do get the middle number. Once you have everything here and it makes sense perfectly, the final answer is just going to be bracket. Okay? But what do you put in the brackets? It's easy. Take a look at the first one. That's your first bracket right there. You just have to add the x in by yourself, okay? And this is a negative 1, so why not just put a negative 1 down there? The second one is the second bracket down here. It's a 3x again, and you get yourself a positive 2. And that's it. There you go. That's a factor of that trinomial up there. Thanks for watching.